But he went to Ephraim, straight directly to Ephraim. He was begging Father Abraham, because the poor man that was prophetically in this house, when this poor man died, the angels of God come. They came and picked him to Abraham. Now, this rich man was begging Father Abraham, please, will you allow Lazarus to dip his finger so that he can have some water? He said, there is a deep pit that lies between us. No one can from here to there. You can also know from your fire, where you are tormenting, that lake of fire, you cannot come to where we are. So that one is over. That's why the Bible says, after death, there is judgment. His own is already judged that you, that is where you belong. That pit, that pain, that torture, that torment, that is the place you belong. But this one that have given life to God, although he was having pain, although he was receiving torture, although he was not having money in his pocket, but he still believed that there is a place that he will have rest. Praise Master Jesus. Now, when the time is gone, the angel take him to Abraham. The Bible says he was by Abraham bosom. But look at this one that were enjoying himself. He was very rich. Remember, Lazarus always went there to his gate to lick the food that fell down for his table. But what happened? They said, there is no space. We cannot cross from here to your side. He said, please, Father Abraham, will you tell Lazarus, allow Lazarus to go to my father's house to tell my brothers, because I still have 5 brothers, so that they will repent, because I don't want them to come to this place where I am receiving torture. The dead, he is dead, he has gone, but he's still evangelizing that heaven is real, hell is real. What are you doing today? How are we going to win soul to Christ? When we are telling people the truth, they will be angry. When we are telling you, God has shown me a fire. I saw it with my clear eyes. When I'm talking about hell, I know what I'm saying. Praise the Lord. If I don't care if you hate me, but the truth of the matter, I want your soul to be saved. Because no one, not tomorrow. I don't know tomorrow. Me that I'm talking, I don't know if I will live to see tomorrow. Praise the Lord. I don't know. When I die, I go, I know that I've tried my possible best to please God. And I've tried my possible best to preach the truth to the children of God. If you like, take it. If you like, don't take it. But where your soul is going, that is where God wants. There is hell. There is heaven. When death wants us to repent, he wants his brothers to repent so that they will not come to where he's receiving torture. What about you? That have opportunity today to give your life to Christ, to take away your hand for what God hates, what God don't want, what you know, the Spirit of God dwells in you. The Spirit of God speaks to you day and night, but you refuse to give them in. But when that day comes, nobody knows. He said, the Bible said, Jesus said, I will come like a thief. The day when I'm coming, I will come like a thief. Praise the Lord. He also gave me some parable that for the slave, for the servant. Sometimes the servant misbehaves. They don't know if the master will come that day. But sometimes the master will come suddenly in the night and open the door and come in. The servant is misbehaving. But that's why the Bible says, that's why we should prepare. Because no one knows, even him don't know the day God allowed him to come to this world for a righteous, for we to disappear, from the righteous and the devil people to depart, because the righteous people we put in one place. He says, first the death, the one that are dead in him, like those that died and they are right with God. When the trumpet blow, those people will rise first and meet him in the sky. We, if we are right with him, we will transform to a glorious clothes. We will also meet him in the sky. But what about you? You believe you are coming to church. You believe you are doing things right. And your way is not pleasing God. What about you? Someone that sits with you, transformed to a glorious clothes, you will leave behind. Then you will be questioning yourself. When God gave you the Holy Spirit that will teach you the truth, that will direct you, that will reveal the secret of God to you. He said, even the angel of God don't know the day. It's only God that knows the day. Because sometimes God himself want to strike the world, but Jesus Christ always prayed. Jesus said in his word, he said, I myself don't know when God will send me to this world. Even the angels don't know. Because God knows, if you allow Jesus Christ to know, the Holy Spirit will tell you. Praise the Lord. Because Jesus loves us. Not like God don't love us, but because the Holy Spirit always reveals the truth. That is the word of God. He says, the Spirit of God, I will ask my Father, he will give you the helper that will reveal the truth about God to you. So now, when God allowed Jesus to know, the Holy Spirit will know. The Holy Spirit will tell you, hey, tomorrow Christ is coming, better behave yourself. That's why God did not inform any of them. So did he. He said, I will come like a thief. That's why it's about time for we to live good. It's about time for we to change our heart. It's about time. If we are really serving God, we need to do what? Give up to God. Let our hearts be given to God. Praise the Lord. Just quickly go to Revelation. Let me tell you about hell. Because if you don't believe in hellfire, I'll set my own. Because the Bible said in the book of Ezekiel, it said, when I send my messenger to deliver my word to my people, that about time, repent, it's time for you to change. And the messenger refused to deliver the word. Whatever that happened to them, God will hold them, hold that messenger responsible if the messenger refused to deliver the word. That's why I don't want anybody's blood to be on my head. God is telling people here that repent. Change for your evil way. Change for your sin. Whatever you are doing, every one of us receive what? We should change. Because on that day, God will not hold me responsible that I did not preach repentance. It's about time. God is telling us to change for our way. Revelation 21 verse 8.
Praise
the
Lord.
Hallelujah.
Revelation 21 verse 8 says, but cowards, traitors, perverts, murderers, the immoral, those who practice magic, those who worship idols and all liars, the place for them is the lake burning with fire and sulfur, which is the second death.
Amen. Praise the Lord. He said, those who practice what? Magic. All liars. Those who fornicate immorality. Those who worship idols. All those people God has mentioned. Listen. Murderer. Fornicator. Immorality. Liars. Those that worship idol. He said the place for them is the lake of what? Of fire. Which what? The second death. You know that I just mentioned that there is afterlife. There is another life. After life, there is life again. After death, there is another death. Which means the lake of fire. If you know you are a liar, you always lie. With little things. Anything, there is no truth in you. The place God has prepared for you is lake of fire. If you know you are the one that commit adultery, fornicator, those that worship another gods, which mean idol worshiper, the place God has prepared for them is what? Lake of fire. They will never escape it. Today, if you know you are a big liar, lie is lie. There is no small one. There is no what? Big one. Any little thing you lie, change your way. If you know you fornicate, turn away from there. If you know you are an idol worshiper, give it up and follow Christ. Because the place God has prepared is lake of fire. God loves us. God don't want our soul to be perished. Remember, because he loved the world, he sent his only begotten son. I will not do that. I will not give my son to die for anybody. But God, because God is God, he loves us, he gives his son to die for you. Now, if you refuse to obey him, to listen to his commandment, he has prepared a place for that person. Lake of fire. Praise Master Jesus. Praise the Lord. This kind of message sometimes is not interesting, but it's for your own good. The Bible said, Apostle Paul said, it is good for me to make you sorrowful. But after a while, the sorrow will go. Later, I will be happy. I will be rejoicing.